The date is September 8, 2010, and we're in Cheyenne, Wyoming, where a real-life mirage stands before us. Union Pacific steam locomotive number 844 is steamed up and ready to go as it prepares to pull a train to Rock Springs, Wyoming, and eventually all the way to Portland, Oregon. While it's unusual to see a large steam locomotive like 844 operating, it's not the only one to do so. There are other big engines running, such as nickel plate 765. Southern Pacific 4449. But 844 stands alone in one respect. The other locomotives both sat for years in city parks, but 844 is the only large steam locomotive never to be retired. It was built for the Union Pacific and has never left the railroad's active roster. In the next hour or so, we'll watch the 844 as she pulls Union Pacific passenger specials over various parts of the UP system. Union Pacific 844 was built in 1944 by the American Locomotive Company and was the last steam locomotive purchased new by the railroad. She has a 484 wheel arrangement, 80-inch driving wheels, and is easily capable of going 100 miles an hour. The 844 was primarily used in passenger service, but as more diesels were purchased, she was used more and more on freight. In 1960, instead of being retired and scrapped, she was held for special service. 844 has hauled all manner of special trains, Union Pacific's version of the Goodyear Blimp or the Budweiser Clydesdales. In 1981, the 844 was joined by the newly restored Challenger locomotive, number 3985, in special service. She'll be traveling along the historic UP Overland route to Granger, Wyoming, where she'll then head northwest along what was once UP's Oregon Short Line subsidiary. For this trip, she'll be running over familiar territory, as she traveled this way many times during her pre-excursion career. It's departure time, and 844 comes to life as she leaves Cheyenne. We are at Hermosa, near the summit of Sherman Hill. The main purpose of the UP STEAM program is public relations, and this is evident in Rawlins, where our train stops to disembark a load of school children. Sometimes railroad photography can be, well, challenging. We did not get another shot of the train until Point of Rocks. The wind was very high, and in addition to being challenging to our microphone, we lost one shot because our camera crew had to duck objects being hurled in the wind. Rock Springs, the train stopped for the night. It seemed as if the entire town turned out to see 844, and like the Pied Piper, they followed her wherever she went. Tomorrow, she'll continue on to Pocatello, Idaho. Thank you. We're just outside of Rock Springs, and 844 is already running at track speed. Ranger, 844 leaves the Overland route to Ogden and turns onto the old Oregon Short Line and heads northwest to Portland. Crew is bedding 844 down for the night in Pocatello. Tomorrow we'll see some fast running as she goes on to Nampa. At Orchard, 844 is stopped, waiting for a high rail truck to clear the track ahead, and we get a chance to look at the old steam locomotive water tank that no doubt served 844 back in the old times. And her crew took the day off on September the 11th. On the morning of the 12th, she was hot and ready to tackle Oregon's Blue Mountains. At Nampa, diesel 8444 was added to the consist to provide dynamic brakes. The steam locomotive was numbered 8444 between 1962 and 1989, and it's no accident that diesel 8444 drew this assignment. This is a day of great scenery. Here our train runs along the beautiful Snake River. Thank you. West of Huntington, we start climbing Encina Hill to the summit of the Burnt River Mountains with a maximum grade of 2.2%. 844 is really working here. The second grade, 844, we'll climb today is Telocasette Hill. This scene is not far from the summit. Thank you. Our train is approaching La Grande, where it will start climbing steep Camela Hill, another 2.2% climb. Our train makes a brief stop at Pendleton. It'll spend several days here on the return trip. Thank you. After spending the night in Hinkle, 844 will run along the beautiful Columbia River as she completes the trip to Portland. 844 has arrived in Portland. Next, we're off to the Midwest, where we'll see her running through different territory. The date is April 7, 2010, and we're in Parsons, Kansas, and 844 is preparing to leave for McAlester, Oklahoma. Parsons was once an important shop town on the old Katy Railroad, and we'll be traveling the Katy's rails today. Our train is once again on a multi-state tour, but we're only going to follow her as far as Fort Worth, Texas.
Thank you.
At Muskogee, a huge crowd turned out to see the 844. The old Katy station in McAlester briefly had a passenger train to serve when 844 pulled in to spend the night.
Thank you.
South of Durant, Oklahoma, our train crosses the Red River and passes into Texas. Denton, another throng of people turned out to see our special train. We're in Fort Worth. UP's PR department has again done its work as the 844 is totally surrounded by onlookers who've come out to look at the steam locomotive. Although 844 continued on south, we're going to rejoin this tour in Gibbon, Nebraska to enjoy some of her trip home. It's April 28, and 844 is about to enter the triple track at Gibbon, Nebraska, as she returns home to Cheyenne. This is the busiest stretch of freight railroad in the world, and 844 moves right along here. We're at the Golden Spike Tower in North Platte. The tower overlooks the massive Bailey Yard and is a perfect place to watch the 844 work her way through this huge facility before she resumes her sprint west. For our last segment, it's May 10th, 2009, and we'll start in Ogden, Utah, where the 844 is laying over on her way east from California. Located here at Union Station is the Utah State Railroad Museum. Exhibits here include 844's sister, 833, a gas turbine, and other exhibits. 844 is moving forward so she can take water and be ready for tomorrow's departure, where she'll head to Rock Springs, Wyoming. It's May 11th, and 844 is about 20 miles east of Ogden. Our train is climbing the 1% Wasatch grade near Castle Rock. At Evanston, Wyoming, yet another large crowd greets our famous locomotive. The roundhouse behind the train was in the process of being restored at the time of this visit. Thank you. We're departing Rock Springs on the final leg of the journey back to Cheyenne.
Thank you.
We've arrived in Cheyenne, and 844 is putting her train away. What's left of the shop building in the background is the home for UP's two active steam locomotives, and soon 844 will be inside being prepared for her next call to duty.